Good afternoon. Welcome to Sacred Hearts Parish. My name is Judy Sullivan, and I'll be the lector for this afternoon. We are glad that you are here with us today. It is with hope that we will all continue to grow together as a community of believers to celebrate God's great gifts to us, God's Word and the Eucharist. Today we celebrate the 23rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our celebrant is Father Kevin. Our Mass intention is for Peter A. Early, Jr. Our second collection is for building and maintenance. Today's second reading reminds us that our lives are to be rooted in love, for love fulfills the law. More specifically, the more we are able to love God with our whole being and to love our neighbors as ourselves, the more we will keep the commandments and experience the blessings God wishes to bestow on us, such as peace, joy, and fulfillment. The challenge for us is to let love be our guiding force. Let us now stand and give praise and glory to our God.
I sing the mighty power of God that made the mountains rise, that spread the flowing seas abroad, and built the lofty skies. I sing the wisdom that ordained the sun to rule the day. The moon shines full at his command, and all the stars obey.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. My sisters and brothers, let us call to mind our sins as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord of mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You intercede for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, creator and ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy, grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, "You, son of man, I have appointed watchmen for the house of Israel. When you hear me say anything, you shall warn them for me. If I tell the wicked, 'O wicked one, you shall surely die,' and you do not speak out to dissuade the wicked from his way, the wicked shall die for his guilt, but I will hold you responsible for his death. But if you warn the wicked, trying to turn him from his way, and he refuses to turn from his way, he shall die for his guilt, but you shall save yourself." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. Come, let us sing joyfully to the Lord. Let us acclaim the God of our salvation. Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving. Let us joyfully sing psalms to him. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. Come, let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the Lord who made us. For he is our God, and we are the people he shepherds, the flock he guides. If today you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Oh, that today you would hear his voice. Harden not your hearts as at Meribah, as in the day of Massah in the desert, where your fathers tempted me. They tested me, though they had seen my works. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, owe nothing to anyone except to love one another, for the one who loves another has fulfilled the law. The commandments, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not kill, you shall not steal, you shall not covet, and whatever other commandment there may be, are summed up in this saying, namely, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no evil to the neighbor. Hence, love is the fulfillment of the law. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ and entrusting to us the message of reconciliation. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, if your brother sins against you, go and tell him his fault between you and him alone. If he listens to you, you have won over your brother. If he does not listen, take one or two others along with you, so that every fact may be established on the testimony of two or three witnesses. If he refuses to listen to them, tell the church. If he refuses to listen even to the church, then treat him as you would a Gentile or a tax collector. Amen, I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Again, amen, I say to you, If two of you agree on earth about anything for which they are to pray, it shall be granted to them by my heavenly Father. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them. The Gospel of the Lord. This portion of Matthew's gospel is sandwiched between two stories of forgiveness. We'll hear the next story next week. I don't want to preclude and tell you the secret before next week. Jesus is speaking about two very difficult realities for us to do. Do you know how difficult it is to confront a loved one? Now, I grew up with two brothers. We had no problem confronting each other to this day. And I know they don't take offense when I may call it as it is, and I know I don't take offense when they call it as it is. But I like to do it one-on-one. And that's how we do it. Jesus is giving us the map, the how to do it. And it's based on something St. Paul writes about years later. In Ephesians, he says, if you are angry, let it be without sin. The sun must not go down on your wrath. Do not give the devil a chance to work on you. Have you ever heard the saying, don't go to bed angry? It comes from St. Paul. And Jesus is enhancing this when he says, if you confront one another, be motivated in love rather than in anger or retaliation. And be sure that you convey to one another the reason for bringing up this concern is that I care for you and I love you. Identify the specific incident or problem and how it made you feel. Listen to the other person's point of view with empathy and understanding. And then resolve the problem with a mutually acceptable agreement. That's the civilized Christian way of confronting someone. What happens if we don't confront them? If we've been hurt? Well, there's the possibility we could hold a grudge. There's the possibility we could try to retaliate. There's a possibility that evil could take hold of our heart and separate us from someone in our family. And so Jesus is reminding us how important it is to settle differences that we may have with others with love and respect. The second point is equally as difficult. How many people here have ever sat down and prayed with their spouse? I'm not asking you to raise your hand, okay? Over 35 years, I've prepared a number of couples for marriage. And one of the things you go through is, you know, making sure they talked about everything. Finances, who's going to take out the trash, you know, who's going to take care of the checkbook. How do you communicate? Make sure you fight fairly. And I find that over the years, couples have no difficulty at all in those issues. The one thing they have the most difficulty with even considering is when I ask, do you pray with each other? Oh, no, we don't do that. What? You're preparing to enter into one of the most intimate relationships for a lifetime, and you've not considered praying with one another? No. I usually have to suggest that as homework, that at least once a week they sit with each other, hold hands, and say a spontaneous prayer, each one of them, to Almighty God, even if it's blessing each other. Why, you ask? Because that is opening the human heart, mind, and soul to the workings of the Holy Spirit. And the very thought that we might ask someone to pray with us is an inspiration of the Holy Spirit. And Jesus is very clear about the impact of this. Where two or three are gathered together in my name, there I am in their midst. And if you agree on earth about anything for which you are to pray, it shall be granted to them by my heavenly Father. I think most of us blow that off. Together as we gather this night in this church, separated by at least 6 feet, wearing masks, we're united here in the name of Jesus Christ, and Jesus Christ is in our midst. In fact, the very fact that we're sitting here is our response to the indwelling invitation of the Holy Spirit prompting us to come. So tonight, let us give thanks to God for that, that we might recognize who is alive in our hearts, who has brought us together this night, and who it is who challenges us to confront with love those who have offended us and resolve issues. If you are angry, let it be without sin. The sun must not go down on your wrath. Do not give the devil a chance to work on you.
Kindly join me in professing the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. In confidence, we lift our petitions to our Heavenly Father.
For the Church, may the Lord graciously preserve and protect her as a sign of his truth to the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all nations, may their leaders be governed by the power of the Holy Spirit in love and service to one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those blinded by sin, may the compassionate mercy of God lead them to goodness and repentance. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations, especially to the priesthood, permanent diaconate, and religious life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community of worship, through the grace of this sacrament, may we be drawn ever more deeply into unity with one another and our triune God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died from the effects of the coronavirus and all who have died, especially Father James Broderick and Joseph Tieran, may they rest in the peace of God's perfect love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Peter A. Early, Jr., who is especially remembered at this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers and concerns listed in our parish book of intentions, and also those we silently call to mind, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For all those serve in our armed forces, for all police, fire, and emergency first responders who are there to serve and protect us, the Lord keep them safe. We pray to the Lord. Amen. God of love and truth, you lead us deeper into relationship with you through every prayer we offer. We ask that you hear the prayers we offer this day through Christ our Lord.
Open my eyes, Lord, help me to see your face. Open my eyes, Lord, help me to see. Open my ears, Lord, help me to hear your voice. Open my ears, Lord, help me to hear. Open my heart, Lord, help me to love like you. Open my heart, Lord, help me to love.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these, your servants' offerings, that what each is offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him with great goodness you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray,
by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Sean, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, 'Peace I leave you, my peace I give you,' look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Standing always at my side, you guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting. Lord, you have searched my heart, and you know when I sit and when I stand. Your hand is upon me, protecting me from death, keeping me from harm. Oh Lord, I know you are near, standing always at my side. You guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting. Where can I run from your love? If I climb to the heavens, you are there. If I fly to the sunrise or sail beyond the sea, still I'd find you there. Standing always at my side, you guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting.
Body of Christ.
You know my heart and its ways. You who formed me before I was born, in the secret of darkness, before I saw the sun, in my mother's womb. Oh Lord, I know you are near. Standing always at my side, you guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting. Marvelous to me are your works, how profound are your thoughts, my Lord. Even if I could count them, they number as the stars,
body,
you would still be there.
Body of Christ.
Oh Lord, I know you are near.
Body of Christ.
Standing
body
always at my side. You guard me from the foe.
Let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Enjoy the weekend. It looks like a beautiful one. And be sure to pray with those you are with. Go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please be seated for our dismissal. Begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. With God as our Father, we are family. Let us walk with each other in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now. With every step I take, let this be my solemn vow. servant and